Meanwhile, in freshwater ecosystems, the first time we've used that one, a disaster is brewing. A new report says that populations of migratory fish have fallen by 3/4 in the last 50 years. Over the same time period, populations of larger species known as megafish have crashed by 94%. And as of right now, 1/3 of all freshwater fish across the face of the earth now face extinction. In fact, they've identified 80 species that have already gone extinct. 16 whole species of freshwater fish went extinct just in 2020 alone. And so how does this work in practice? So in the UK, for instance, the sturgeon and the burbot have vanished. Salmon are disappearing and the European eel remains critically endangered. So that's in the UK, but this is a problem the world over. It's being driven by the poor state of rivers, mostly as a result of pollution, dams and sewage. And why is this a problem? Well, I think fairly obviously a problem for a lot of reasons, these species as well. So we're focusing on the freshwater fish now, but we've talked about animal species broadly, bees, all of this. They all seem to be doing really poorly. Maybe it's something we should look into, but this in particular is a problem because, for instance, about 200 million people across Asia, Africa and South America rely on freshwater fishers for their main source of protein. And about 1/3 of those people also rely on them for their jobs and livelihoods. And so as those species are devastated and go extinct, you potentially have literally hundreds of millions of people who are going to lose access to one of the main sources of their protein intake. That is a devastation waiting for us in the near future. I think we lost your mic input.
No, yeah. So this is a climate change issue. I mean, have we tracked back to where this is happening directly?
So climate is definitely a component of it, but also pollution, rivers being stopped up for dams. There's a number of different things that are part of this. Climate is certainly one of them.
And I'm sure this isn't the first time this has been pointed out. Have we ignored it to the point now where it's one in every three fish is now in this issue?
He's under threat of extinction. Yes,
I don't have much faith that this is going to change. That anything's going to switch off this. If you can see this happening, and it's not the first time, I'm sure anyone's reported this type of phenomenon. They can go, oh, 1 in 3. That means 2 out of 3 are still around. Good job. I'm telling you, that's the way a lot of minds will work.
That might be actually.
I don't really need a whatever random fish that they've never heard of. I don't need that. It's okay. It's just the way we think, and it's why we're here already. Reversing people's mindsets on how our ecosystem and everything works and what's needed is an impossibility. Sorry.
Maybe, or at least it's certainly a fight. You know, people who
it's worth having. Like, I don't mean to be that negative.
No, it's worth having the conversation. Well, let's see how many people watch a video on YouTube that's talking about freshwater fish to give you an idea of people's concern about it. But then also people who do care about this are considered kooks in some way, or about animals broadly. Like we did a story a year or two ago about the fall of different insect species. And I think a lot of people respond sort of like you said, like, oh good, I don't like insects. No, but it's important. And when we're losing 80 or 90% of a lot of these different species, that is devastating. We have a lot of issues that we have to deal with, but the earth is being stripped of its life at an unprecedented rate. Something to look into. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.